20 seconds left, 20 seconds left.
Scenes from Gaffney Fitness Center, Fort Meade Police, the 241st MPs and other Gaffney patrons participating in a 90-minute plank challenge to promote suicide prevention and awareness. Hello and welcome to Meade Week. I'm Brian Spann. Also this week, Army working on a backlog of DD-214s. AFES extends some facility hours, and we continue our series on the new electronic health record system, MHS Genesis. These stories and more, but first, Anne Arundel County Public Schools hosted a recent press conference announcing the implementation of the Be Present initiative.
The reason why we are here today is in a conversation with our school board a couple of weeks ago, in a conversation with our executive leadership team, and even in my meetings with building principals, I have spoken to them about the fact that school violence is real. These threats that are happening around the country, around the state, around the nation, they are real. And we are not immune from these trends.
The initiative invites parents, guardians, alumni, and the community at large to have a greater presence in county schools to help make them safer and more efficient.
To be clear, our volunteers won't be asked to do security or discipline. We just want them to be present. We want to build relationships. We want to form bonds.
In other news, the Army's new human resources system, IPSE, a system that enables soldiers to access their personnel and pay records at any time, went online in December. But the implementation wasn't without issues. A backlog of DD-214s, that all-important piece of paper that's issued at separation or retirement, providing proof of service, was created when the legacy system didn't coordinate with IPSE. We spoke with the Fort Meade Garrison Director of Human Resources about the issue and its effect here at Fort Meade.
So 214s process ran into issues as IPSE came online, and Transproc was one of the legacy systems that was going to sunset with IPSE. So they took Transproc down in December to migrate all the data into IPSE, and when they brought it all back up, they realized that the functionality of 214s was not operating correctly in IPSE. Right now, Transproc is back operational. There are a few issues that they're working out still with Transproc. However, we do not have a significant backlog of any 214s here at Fort Meade, as they've been using the workarounds and processing them through other means. At Fort Meade, we have a couple of tweaks here and there that we're making, but yes, we're not tracking a large backlog of 214s that need to be done.
Smith advises anyone approaching retirement or separation to come in and get the processing started as soon as possible. Army officials add that if a soldier is already on transition leave or already separated, they'll receive a copy of their 214 in the mail and in IPERMs. Turning to some news from the exchange, AFES has announced extended hours for the Main Exchange and the Meade Express. The new hours take effect Saturday, February 11th. The Main Exchange will close an hour later, 8 p.m. Monday through Saturday, and at 7 p.m. on Sunday. The express closing time is now 9 p.m. every day. Exchange officials say that hours at other AFES facilities are being examined, but for now it's just the Main Exchange and the express. Meanwhile, a couple of items from Kimbrough Ambulatory Care Center. First, mammography services are being interrupted while a new 3D mammography unit is being constructed. Construction is expected to be completed by March 16th. If you're due for an annual exam, you may see treatment at another military treatment facility, the civilian market, or wait until the new unit is up and running. In more health news, if you're a Meade Week regular, you know we've been running a series of videos on MHS Genesis, the DoD's new electronic health record system. In this video, the importance of making sure your deer's information is up to date before accessing MHS Genesis.
Did you know that the MHS Genesis patient portal is the easiest way for you to access your medical records? That's right, but before you start with your TRICARE benefits, you should check that your information is correct in deer's. Simply go to the web page shown on the screen to verify your mailing address, phone numbers, and email addresses. Why should you update DEERS? Any information that is not correct can cause problems with claims, referrals, and delivery of home prescriptions, so it is critical to keep it updated. For more information about the patient portal, visit health.mil/MHSGenesis.
And that's Meade Week for this week. I'm Brian Spann. For everyone at Meade TV and the Fort Meade Public Affairs Office, have a great weekend and a great Meade Week.